You ask yourself, is there a past? If it don't take that, you can't say there's a past or a future. The same with the future. If you ask yourself, is there a future? If it don't think about it, you can't say there's a future. If people say, I was in the past, or I was in the future, and they believe that they were in the past or in the future. But have a look at it again. Can you actually live in the past? Can anyone actually live a moment ago? Or last week, or last year? Realise that you can't go back and live it. What you can do is record. And then a recollection of what it was, not actually was, just the recollection, the memory of it. But when that recollection is, when does that recollection happen? You can only record right in this moment. You can't tell me what you did 5 minutes ago unless you record it. Or last week, or last year, or with your little son. Or any other conditioning you think about, you can't, unless you're recalling and bringing it into the present right now with thought, it's got no substance at all, no reality. So the same with the future. You can imagine and anticipate the future, next week, next month, tomorrow, 5 minutes time, what I'll do tomorrow. And you're not actually living in the future. You're just imagining it, and when you're imagining it, it's always right now. So when people tell you, I have trouble staying in the now, have a look and see that it's impossible to get away from now. Though you might be believing it and thinking. You can only believe it when you're not questioning along the lines of what you're doing, saying to yourself that you're in the past or the future. In doing that, you realise that you never ever moved away from now at any time. This is always the actuality. Even if it's past thoughts or so-called past thoughts or so-called future thoughts, the only life they've got is what they've been given in this moment. So when we say that time is a mental concept. And another thing we tell you is you won't find the answer in the mind. Say in the science, you've looked at this and looked at that, done all sorts of meditations, all sorts of practice that most of us have. All sorts of retreats and God knows what, and then I went trying to find the answer and trying to get in touch with this reality. And you search for so many years in the mind with all these things and never found it. And when we say the answer is not in the mind, maybe it might just dawn on you that you've been looking in the wrong direction. Because you work out a lot of other things in the mind, and very useful instruments. The answer to life, or whatever you like to call it, or realisation, or liberation, or whatever it is, and you never found it in the mind. It might just dawn on you, maybe it's not in the mind. And if that dawns on you, what do? You realise that you have a look and see which every direction you look in the mind, is always in the mind. No matter what direction you're looking. And there's only one way out of the mind, and that again is full stop. And the pausation of a thought. Now, is there such a thing as mind there without a thought? People say my mind and believe that this mind is a very powerful instrument, wonderful instrument. Is there such a thing? Can anybody show me a thing called mind? We take it for granted. It's my mind. I have a mind. I don't do you. You have something. With any substance really independent nature from core mind. Is there such a thing as part of mind apart from thinking? And if it's thought, which particular thought is it? Now the primary thought, that sense of presence expressing through the mind, expresses as the thought I am. That thought has been acquired or learned. You didn't have it when you were a little child. So if you were thought, you would be that primary thought, I am. Do you go around saying I am all day, every day? To confirm your being sure that you need to keep it in mind constantly. Yeah, you go. But we don't think of it at all a lot of the time throughout the day. And it's not there when you sleep. Unconscious. If they're unconscious or asleep, or under an anesthetic or something. And you don't disappear without it. Again, proof that you're not that thought. And is there any other thought you are? You see, thoughts are constantly coming and going. And thought, if you look at it closely, which we call mind, a group of thoughts, all mind, if you look at thought closely, you'll see the way it functions, it's always functioning in the pairs of opposites. At the subtle level, thinking is a very, very subtle vibration. When it comes out as word, which is sound, sound is a vibration, and the vibration is a movement of energy. So it's still that intelligence energy, just the same as this body is a pattern of intelligence energy. It's the same as all this manifest object.